another educator, a teacher, abusing a child, allegedly special education teacher, put her up, full mass here. I'm going to give you the background to this. Special education teacher has been arrested after allegedly slapping and using a ruler to hit students. Law enforcement has now charged her with one felony count of abuse. I'm going to give you the background. The teacher, her name is Adrean Johnson. Ms. Johnson was hired by Harns Marsh Elementary. This is 6 months before another teacher observed her inappropriate behavior and reported that behavior to the administration. That's according to NBC2. On Wednesday, March 29th, a teacher says she witnessed Johnson, 39 years of age, hitting a child and reported the disturbing incident to the school resource officer. The school called authorities, who launched an investigation after removing Johnson from the classroom. The Lee County Sheriff's Office interviewed students and teachers on the campus and gathered evidence regarding Johnson's classroom conduct. Let me give you the sheriff, all right? So you're looking at Carmine Marchino. In a statement released on Facebook, he says, and I quote, "Our special victims unit worked with the Lee County School District to address this situation immediately, and the suspect has been charged accordingly." Adding, "We take this type of behavior very seriously, especially involving children, as they should. The investigation is still active, and additional charges are possible forthcoming as we continue our investigation with the Lee County School District." An investigation said they found the teacher had slapped a child in the face with her bare hand. Bare hand. It also showed she disciplined her grammar school students by hitting them on the legs and back and using a ruler to strike them on their buttocks, according to Lee County Sheriff's Office. Students interviewed by the Special Victims Unit called the ruler she used when they were misbehaving the powwow stick, all right? One of Johnson's alleged victims did have documented behavioral issues, still wears diapers. This child, whose name is being withheld because of age, never told the grandmother about the abuse. She became aware of the abuse after noticing red marks on her child's body, all right? Let's put up the picture again of the educator who has been accused of this kind of behavior. And I want to remind everyone, it's important to keep the lines of communication open with young people all the time, all the time. So in this case, you have an alleged instance of abuse, but you also have a pattern. That pattern allegedly is connected to not only slapping a child, but creating a discipline because of an educational academic dynamic. You are a special education teacher. There's a certain care and love and respect and honor about that position. It is a noble position. I know many special education teachers, good friends of mine. They have the biggest hearts I've ever seen. I mean that. So, madam, you engaging in this kind of activity allegedly, is contrary to the spirit of what you represent or should represent. So now the authorities are involved. Investigation is happening. I'm glad the Lee County School District did report. Sheriff got involved immediately. The accusation was leveled when they got the evidence. This is how it should operate. Even though no one should be in the school system abusing children, when abuse happens, there has to be a report, there has to be action, there has to be execution of that action. And now you have it. Too many times we've reported on children being abused, and for some reason, they just don't get around to the discipline part of the educator until we get involved. This time, they did it before we got involved. Big ups to Lee County. All right, we'll follow it as it continues. Ricky, thoughts here?
Yeah, you know, that's really sad because kids are, special needs kids, already going through things that they have to deal with every day and trying to make an adjustment to life and just try to figure out how to navigate. And, you know, that's a special calling, you know, when you get get the, you know, to handle, you know, special need kids or whatever. And you can't hit them and take them through stuff. You know, life is already hard for them. Yep. You know, they got to deal with being bullied. They got to deal with other issues, how to navigate, how to function. Then they become adults or whatever. And just imagine having those issues. And then you get abused on top of that, on top of your mental condition. Now, I tell you what, if she would did that one to mine, I would rather
you go.
But you know, you can't do that, Dr. Richey. You can't put your hands on kids or whatever, because those kids have issues, and you're supposed to be a trained professional to help those kids navigate through. You know, through whatever they have to navigate through, but it's unprofessional, and she should face jail time for that.
Yeah. You know, those who work in that arena, they receive significant specialized training. They have tools and resources that we do not. They understand things that we do not. They have a capacity that many people do not.
It seems like they're going to have to start putting surveillance cameras in those classrooms, you know, because stuff like that just can't happen.
That's right. And that has been an option on the table before. Obviously, we need to go and revisit it.